talked to, and I legit got like maybe 15 people.
Dear City goes hard.
Yeah, I was actually concerned. I was texting her, and I was like, I don't know.
From high end to like new brands, like all my shit to me. I just want you to try it and hopefully post about it or do whatever. But I think the one thing that I found that really I swear by, or those right there, was the salt cleansing pads from the cleansing foam. And that really changed how I do my skincare, because
it's essentially a double cleanse, right?
It's a double cleanse, as you know so well. I learned that from Charlotte, the double cleanse kind of thing. But when I first got to Korea and I started putting makeup on, I didn't know you could take it like completely off. Because nobody teaches you that, right? But you have to remove oil, and then you have to remove with a water base, so you get everything out. And what I realized, so they were like, I'm gonna try this oil, try this oil. And I was pumping it into my hand, and then by the end of it, my entire head, everywhere was just oil. So I feel like I was taking a shower.
I think people like that image.
Foam, which is, feels really good.
Oh my gosh, it feels so luxurious, and I'm trying to try like every single foam there is in the market, and it's so luxurious. It just like comes out like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like a
velvety.
It's velvety.
Yeah.
And it also has really good ingredients. And you know me, I'm very strict about my ingredients in my products, and the fact that these are under $25
each. Wow.
It's pretty amazing. The price point is
accessible,
and it's really well formulated. So
how many products do you test?
$36
I feel like your house must be
kind of insane, but we have a whole team now that works on it. If you're just in the back, who helps with all the and what's great is that like everyone has different skin types and concerns.
Right.
So I have dry. I don't know if you have oily or or perfect skin, I don't know. So everyone has different skin types, so we need to make sure when we test all of these products that it's suited for different skin types and skin concerns. So that's why everything down here is based on skin concerns, and upstairs is by product type.
Okay, cool. So yeah, any other, were there more questions?
The other question I had was, did you get any questions? Did you ask any questions? Oh yeah, they wanted to ask you about what's your favorite sheet mask?
My favorite sheet mask?
Do you use sheet masks a lot?
I do, but I've tried
so many.
A billion of them. Actually, this is not. Oh wait, what do I like? I like actually like those molding bags.
Oh really?
Yeah. Look presentable. and wake up and like, oh my God. But I think everybody has those days, you know. I think I would love to just be able to say like, I don't care, but that would be a lie, to be very honest, you know. I think it's, we live in a world, fortunately or unfortunately, where everything is documented and posted and shared constantly, and I would like for myself to think like, I want to present like the best like side of myself to people because I am in the public eye often. Having said that, I don't think it stresses me out at all. I don't think it really bothers me. I like to think of it as like, if I have a day where I'm just completely, in most days, I'm just in sweats, flip-flops, and like a hat, and that's like all I wear. Like, I'm cool like sharing that as well, but people know that's what I'm like, down in. So I think it's, everything in balance is cool, and I don't think it's like a weird, like, overwhelming burden or not sure what I feel.
Just one more, and then we'll do the raffle.
Yeah, we'll take you in the back and over again.
What about the
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay,
I know you gotta open the store again, so. So, we'll go, yeah, be in the back.
Oh, hey. Okay. Hi, my name's Onyx.
Okay.
Hi. I forgot, but I thought, oh, yeah. So, kind of broad, but where do you get your inspiration from for your music?
My music?
Yeah.
I think it's just every day. Life and experiences and like the conversations that I have with friends. And I think when I travel, I tend to have a lot of ideas because I'm on a plane with nothing to do for a long time, and then I just think about life and how crazy it is. Like, I'm on a plane going to whatever city or country to do whatever. And then I go like deep dive into my brain of like, but why is this? And what's there when it's gone, and like what, like all that kind of stuff. And so those are things that I think I really source my lyrics or my material from. And I think, not that you asked, but if I'm, you know, oversharing maybe a little bit, but I was just writing Nashville, and like, what do you want to write about? And like, I think right now I want to write about just being overwhelmed in ways. I think just like so many things going on in the world and in life and the people around me, like they're not bad things, but there's just a lot going on. And like, how do we process that as people? And like, what's a good way to understand that and accept that, be that positive or negative? So that's, for example, like a song that I wrote in Nashville a few days.
Saw that Instagram post.
What's that?
Saw that Instagram post.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, I don't know, one of the, I don't know. Writing an album from scratch with a story in mind, it can kind of constrain what you're trying to do. So I'd rather, every session that I go into, it's a different songwriter, it's a different producer, and I'd rather that entire session be about the vibe that I did. Like, I'll walk in with a topic of, like, global warming. And then we're like, let's write the best song about global warming that we can.
Yeah.
knows that there's a Gucci belt. Maybe I want it for you.
Can we do a quick video?
Yeah!
I don't know. Listen, I had it propped up the whole time.